I don't really know how much you know about me, but I'm probably the most vocal anti-children transitioning person on the internet. It's what I'm, right. I let you speak.
The best thing you can do for us is grow out your mustache and tell people not to live like you. You know, I think it's really funny that she's quoting scripture as a liberal, thinking that she can use it against us as Christians. You know, it's like, oh, it doesn't apply to me, but maybe it'll work on you. And guess what? It doesn't work. Playing on our Christian compassion and making us be tolerant and accepted of all this diversity, you know what that's left us with? Transgender pedophiles on Twitter saying that your daughter asked for it, your little girl isn't actually a princess, she asked for it when I abuse her. That is where we're at. So you're throwing scripture at me as a liberal is not going to work. You cannot play the Christian compassion card on us anymore. We are standing, we are taking a stand for social conservatism because it matters. Social issues matter. And using God's word and manipulating it to try to get Christians to agree with you is absolutely subversive. And that's what we're struggling with in our party, is subverters. You know, how many kids saw Blaire White, you know, giving one of her videos? You know, I know Trump is a cash cow. I know people love to talk about him and their popularity, but how many children saw her and looked at her and said, you know what, she looks really good. I could do that too, and started transitioning. This is about the children. They are coming for our kids, and we are at a point now where we're going to have to take a stand. Will the party go the way of the LGBTQ? Will the party, you know, we already have a transgender man, woman, it, I don't know, in California running the Federation for Republican Women. You know, are we going to let this stand, or are we going to choose to stay with the nuclear family and support the nuclear family? Because from what I've seen from these LGBTQ activists, such as Richard Grenell, who's an absolute pervert, he refuses to stand up for transgenders in the military, against transgenders in the military. He refuses to stand and make a public statement that, hey, men shouldn't be in women's bathrooms. That's because they're bought, sold, and paid for by these LGBT donors who have seen an opportunity. Trump was a cash cow. He was. You talk about him and you are, you know, had a different look or whatever, people would throw themselves at him. It's like, oh, look how inclusive we are. But we're sacrificing everything. And when it comes down to it, I choose the life, preserving the life of little children who are, 15% of them are growing up identifying as LGBTQ and transgender, and we should not be giving a spotlight to or a platform to people who operate in a lifestyle where 40% of them end up attempting suicide, you know, eventually. You know, 1 in 4 children growing up struggling with LGBTQI gender dysphoria end up with depression, drug abuse. I think it's 80% of men have a higher risk of HIV. You know, why would I support that lifestyle? Why would I even make excuses for that lifestyle or try to use
it? Blair, can you respond to your statements real fast? Because I know Blair has a hard out. We haven't heard from Blair. Just on the...